We are at the fag end of this of the session. So what we're going to do discuss today in this session is more in terms of having security being delivered as a service from the cloud versus on-premise deployment of security, right? Now, in my personal experience with Netmagic, I've seen this debate happening with customers ever so often on whether to go with on-premise security solutions or to deploy cloud-based security solutions, right? And to that extent, we have a very comprehensive portfolio of services which offers both options to customers as the need may be, right? It's quite befitting that we are having this discussion at the end of this particular day, because this will focus more in terms of how to deliver security, right? Whether on-premise or through the cloud. So in the throughout the day, you must have gone through what needs to be delivered for security, or what needs to be in place, what controls need to be in place. Now we'll talk about the how. So I think let me quickly begin. The introductions have already been done. So I'll begin with, Shamil. Can you share your thoughts in terms of using security as a service or platforms versus on-premise? What are the aspects customers need to consider in terms of scalability, cost, effectiveness?
Okay. Good evening. Security, compliance, and data sovereignty are the three major issues the customer think today for hosting the applications on the cloud platform and basically getting information resiliency and the type of privacy the organization wants to maintain is very, very difficult to get in-house. If on-premise hosting or application requires the security services which can be given from a hosting service cloud provider, it is anticipated well that the organization has to invest a lot in terms of the tools, in terms of the software, and in terms of human resources which will be required to run those tools. And cloud service providers, they already have deployed a very good set of tools which can be configured through a click for the applications the customer hosts. So basically, opting for a security services from the cloud provider is always very convenient and economic for the customers who are hosting their applications. However, we have a wrong concept about cloud breaches. Now, some of the major breaches which have happened, they have happened in banks who have complete in-house hosting. And some of the hosting which we have seen to have been breached are normally hosted on cloud, but then they are the social security sites and file sharing sites. And that makes a very big story that cloud is insecure. Actually, companies cannot really provide that much of security which a cloud service provider can provide, because their tools are shared by multiple tenants and the cost and the economics is much better. One problem with the organizations is that when we talk of security, it is not a security of the infrastructure which is not that important. It is the culture of the employees which is very important. When you host an application, unless you do a proper security application test or you follow the policies, you are bound to be insecure whether you are on-premise or on the cloud. So what I would suggest is that customers should concentrate on following the policies and really ensure that before their applications are hosted on the internet, they should do a proper security application check and then only host it. I think this is the part which I wanted to tell, and I hand over to Shomok for the next part.
Excellent. Yeah. So Shomok, would you like to share your thoughts on that?
Good evening, everyone. So there was a time when I was one of the CISOs who used to say no to security from the cloud. So I was one of those people who are those typically there they are the ones who resist security from the cloud or cloud security. Today, I believe and I thoroughly converted to someone who believes in security from the cloud. So let us try to understand, I mean, from my own personal example, what made me convert into someone from a no to yes for cloud security. The reasons for adopting security solutions from the cloud would be very much similar to reasons for adopting data center or infrastructure from the cloud. The reasons are definitely agility, faster time to deploy, proven use cases, lesser manageability or better manageability, I mean lesser number of people I have to employ. The benefits are enormous. There was a time when companies used to deploy firewalls, IPSs, anti-APTs, all in their perimeter, all in their own networks. And the time and resources they have to spend in managing and operating them and then making a SOC out of them and to have a total picture of the cybersecurity would be enormous for these companies. Today, when you have proven use cases which are being offered from the cloud, I think the client just have to, it's like going and switching on something. But there are still some people who still believe that security should not be offered from the cloud. These are the people who believe in the privacy of the data. When I say no to cloud security or no to security from the cloud, actually I am concerned about the privacy of my data, and I'm thinking that should I trust this company to provide security for all the data that my company is transacting? So privacy of the data is the one concern which is biggest in my mind at that point of time. So I think to have a fairly balanced ecosystem where all of us are cooperating and coexisting, I think that these cloud service providers must bring in more transparency in their operations where they can give a higher level of data assurance or assurance about the privacy of customer data, and that is why third-party assurance frameworks are also very important.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Shomak. So, you know, actually we have a very great mix of the panel members here because all three of them have worked as, you know, either in capacity as an end user organization or even as a service provider. So, Partho Sarthi, I'd like to throw that same question at you and understand your views on it.
Yeah, good evening. Well, when you talk about cloud versus on-premise setup, it's a call which very consciously the organization has to take as to what should be the balance and what should be the migration path towards going to the cloud. Generally, we have seen that adoption of a cloud even now is based on a couple of things, which is one is very critical is the security of it, and there is a fear in the organization and in the top management in terms of how secure my data will be. So for testing and for seeing and for evaluating how they are going to do it, they are generally migrating their non-critical data first and then checking it out and then eventually going and putting their critical data also. By this, they are coming across whatever threats they are handling it, and again, the organization has to look at the cost of doing it and the expertise that they have. So amount of expertise that a cloud service provider will be able to give and the amount of security that cloud service provider will be able to give will be immense in terms of what organization will be able to provide at on-premise. So it's a balance that they have to do, and it's a balance of what kind of cloud they should go for, whether it should be a public cloud, a private cloud, or a hybrid cloud, and what kind of a security they will be going for and at what stage. So that judgmental call and that migration path has to be designed well so that the migration happens seamlessly.
Can I add something to what Partho said? So I'd love to add something to what Partho said. Security would be one of the last things that a company would want to migrate to the cloud. When you're looking at the transformation journey of any corporate, the first applications which go to the cloud are the less critical ones, which do not handle critical data or confidential data of the company. It can be a CRM. It can be a customer-facing application. It can be even email. Those are the first ones which go to the cloud. Security is something which encompasses all my applications, which carries the data of all applications. Hence, once a client is convinced that an email solution or a CRM solution is good enough on the cloud, and then gradually my ERP is good enough on the cloud, then he moves security. So by that time, please understand that he has already been convinced about the benefits of cloud migration. So reasons for migrating security to the cloud would be very much similar to what the reasons are for migrating any other service to the cloud, any other critical service rather. Thank you.
So thank you all. I think round one definitely gives a good thumbs up to cloud security in terms of how it can offer better scale, lower costs, and more effectiveness. In terms of the security controls. And again, what we have observed is there's a shift happening in the market where more and more customers are now actually moving to the cloud. And when I say cloud, I'm referring it to in the loosely in terms of either a data center or a public cloud environment, right? The hyperscale providers. So to that extent, security now is also being like a near premise rather than an on-premise thing, right? And it's actually helping out the use case of security as a service. Now, I think all three of you touched upon the fact of why, what kind of concerns customers have, right? And probably that's the reason why the adoption rates are not very high when it comes to security as a service. However, the next question that I want to put across is in terms of what should customers then look for? Okay, I mean, we have in the audience CISOs, CIOs, digital risk officers. What should they be looking at when they are evaluating a particular security technology in terms of, whether cloud-based will be good or whether on-premise will be good? Are there certain security controls which are better delivered from the cloud and some better delivered on-premise? Is cloud security, security as a service rather, is it better for certain types of organizations like maybe startups and SMEs and not so for enterprises? So, Shomok, I would like to start with you. And
So I think, let us assume that the brand that I have chosen for on-site deployment is the same that the cloud service provider is giving. So I should not be having any problem. The choice of the cloud service provider is the same as the choice that I have. So what is the differentiating factor or factors that would make me to go for the CSP and not for on-site deployment? I think if the MSP or the CSP can give me a very good use case, and he already knows what are the use cases that I have, and he can prove to me via live POCs, which are much more easier to be done in a cloud environment than making the cloud testing environment in my own premise, I think that can click the case in favor of the CSP. I know the product. I'm convinced about the technical strength and weaknesses of the product. What is left is the manageability part. And if the manageability part and the benefits part of that are taken care of better in the cloud environment, and the reporting is very important. If I see that I don't have to employ people, I am getting the same product, the same benefits, but the reporting quality is very good, the MIS that's coming out to me is very good, is effective to me, I think that will actually convince me to go for the same product but as a cloud service. Thank you.
Well, I would like to mention two lines here. Well, data security is our major concern, and if I have to suggest you something, gradually people are going to the cloud. Data can also be put on the cloud, even gradual secure data can be put on the cloud. However, ensure that the data is encrypted and the customer has the keys for the encryption. Never give the keys to the cloud provider so that it's under your control. Second thing is very important. When you think of, when you learn about credit cards data being hacked, it is the hacker who has hacked the application. The application was weak, and that's why the credit card data was hacked. So if there is an application which is very secure, you can very confidently give that application for hosting in the cloud service providers, and let cloud service provider provide the necessary security systems to protect your application. But before that, you have to ensure that your application is not vulnerable.
Thank you, Shamal. I think that's a very unique, a very specific point that you brought out in terms of encryption. So I'm sure that would be of use to a number of people in the audience. Partho Sarthi, I would like to know your views on this.
It's very obvious that keeping anything at premise is a huge amount of cost, maintenance, and then you have a huge issue with regard to manpower who will be managing it. So it's always good to give it to experts to do it for you. So the way forward will definitely be to go towards cloud, but for migration from on-premise towards the cloud will have to be a gradual path, then a shutdown and restart there. So that has to be a judgmental call, which will definitely will have a lot of say of the CIO and the management in terms of how they want to do it and with whom they want to go it. So that is what my views on.
We must understand one thing, the rate of recovery or the percentage of recovery of a cloud service provider from an attack is much higher than the percentage of recovery from the same attack of a corporate or an organization. Because the service provider is in a better position, is in a better shape with more security controls, and that is why it can recover from an attack faster. Okay, even agility in recovery is much higher in a cloud service provider. So this brings us back to the question that why have at all gone to the cloud? Because whatever the basic or most of the hacks that have happened in the cloud space are not due to inherent flaws of the cloud infrastructure. They are mostly due to inherent flaws of the customer's equipment and due to basic processes, basic hygiene not being followed, which can happen very much in a cloud environment, which can happen very much in your own environment. So let's not blame the cloud. I'm a very much proponent of, everything from the cloud, and gradually I'm also being converted to cloud security or security from the cloud. So let's try to bring up an environment where we follow the basic hygiene, be it on the cloud or be it at my own home.
Okay. I don't know. Probably just 5 more minutes, and I knew that cybersecurity is making a lot of noise. I was hoping it was a bit metaphoric in nature and not literal. But so be it. But we'll continue even if they shut off the lights, right? So we have to say what we have to say. Wind up very quickly, just 5 minutes more. We all talked about migrating to cloud. We all talked about the benefits of cloud and the on-premise. Let me start with you, Parthasarathy, on this one. What is the role system integrators and service providers need to play in this whole ecosystem now?
As a system integrator or as a service provider of, say, the cloud infrastructure or, say, the one who connects your cloud to your premise is where we play a major role. So it is very much important for a customer in terms of whether he wants to choose a service provider and how he wants to connect to them, plus how critical his data and his applications are and what all he wants to put on cloud. In terms of his accessibility of those that information and the way he wants to keep it is very, very critical in terms of how he wants to connect to those solutions. So as an internet service provider or as a cloud service provider or as an infrastructure provider who is providing data center services, it is very much important that we stitch everything together so that the migration and the experience of the customer and his internal employees and his customers is seamless.
Okay, understood. So in the interest of time, right, for Shomak and Shamal, either you can choose to answer that question or if you have any closing thoughts on the overall debate, either way that you would want to take it.
Okay, just a small thought. A cloud service provider cannot be someone separate from me. He's part of my own ecosystem. Okay, when I'm actually finally choosing to outsource some of my controls to the cloud, it is after a lot of thinking. And a cloud service provider just cannot stay outside my ecosystem and provide giving the services like a service provider. Yes, this is the scenario right now, but gradually going forward, cloud service providers have to be more collaborative with the client. The pain points of the client have to be experienced by the cloud service provider himself. And gradually as this do, it will become more of collaboration where everybody understands each other's pain points and problems.
I think what Mr. has told is very correct, that it has to be a trust between the cloud service provider and the customer, and the customer should ensure that they are also providing the similar type of policies and security norms in their premises as the cloud service provider is doing, and vice versa. Then only a proper handshake will work and security will be really, really successful.
All right, thank you everyone. I think we have a very clear distinction here, right? Shomak obviously is definitely a very strong cloud proponent and will go all out for having security as a service delivered from the cloud, and we have a more balanced view from Parthasarathy and Shyamal in terms of the organization culture that needs to be in place, the collaboration that needs to be in place between the service provider and the end user organization. Now, by the way, the bell hasn't gone off yet, so I'm going to open this out to the audience and ask if they have any question. Really? Okay. Okay, well, that's my cue. She's already out there on the podium. So I thank you, everyone. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I would request Mr. Sudipto Bishwas to kindly come up on the stage and hand over the memento to our moderator, Mr. Rishikesh Kamath. At the same time, I would request Mr. Rishikesh Kamath to hand over the mementos to Mr. Partho Sarathy Dash, Mr. Shomok Shok, Mr. Shyamal Bhattacharya. Of today's program, ladies and gentlemen, may I please call up on the stage Mr. Kaushik Bhattacharya to deliver the vote of thanks.
Thank you. On behalf of InfoSec Foundation, I wholeheartedly would like to thank Government of West Bengal, Kolkata Police for wholeheartedly supporting our initiative. You must have heard from, you know, different police authorities, how exactly we were trying to do good for the overall society. I would really like to thank speakers from all across the country and outside who has come in and made the content very rich. I would also like to thank all our sponsors, without whom actually we cannot even think of doing such a program. I would also sincerely like to thank our volunteers. I would like to thank, you know, DSCI, NASCOM, our industry partner. I would also like to thank NASCOM East for, you know, supporting the cause and always staying with us. Also like to thank all our ICT industry colleagues, you know, extending their cooperation and making this really a grand success. We have a lot of volunteers, event managers, sponsors, people helping in digital marketing, so on and so forth. Difficult to name each one of them now, but we, on behalf of the foundation, wholeheartedly thank everybody. This is a non-profit foundation. We promise that we will carry on this initiative for the society at large in coming days with different kind of events and initiatives.